Hi students, this video is about contingency tables and we're going to start learning about probability using contingency tables. First I want to start with Venn diagrams though, something we've done before. So I've got a problem here and I want to use the Venn diagram and then show you how that relates to a contingency table. So let's read this. 250 households were surveyed and 180 said they have a cat, 95 said they have a dog, and 52 said they have a cat and a dog. Fill in the Venn diagram and the contingency table. Okay, so let's do the Venn diagram first. You might remember doing these. We have to start with the inside. 52 said they have a cat and a dog, so that's both. And in the sets, that's where the sets overlap each other. So 52 have both. The reason we can't go right to these is this is cat only, but this 180 said they have a cat. So this 52 is included in the 180 because these two numbers together will add up to 180. So if you want to try doing this, you can just pause the video and try it yourself and then check. Otherwise, just keep watching. So I'm going to take 180. That said they have a cat and subtract the 52 that said they also have a dog. Okay, so let's do that. 180 minus 52 is 128 that have essentially a cat only, right? Or at least in terms of cats and dogs. They could have a fish or rabbit or something else. Okay, now for the dog owners. 95 said they have a dog, but we know 52 also have a cat, so let's subtract that. 95 minus 52 is 43. So 43 dog only, 52 have both in the intersection. And then remember we have this number outside in the universal set for people that don't have a cat or a dog. So do we have that number? We don't, so we have to calculate that. So we know that we have 250 households altogether. So how can we figure out the number that goes outside here? If you said add these three up and subtract, you're right. We could either do 250 minus that, minus that, minus that, or we could add them all up first and then subtract. Let's add them all up. 128 plus 52 plus 43. I'll do it by hand. So 13, that's 10, 12, 223. So have one of these pets or both. So if we take 250 minus 223, it's 27. Okay, so 27 households surveyed had neither a cat nor a dog. Okay, so far so good. These are some things we've done before so far. Now let's take a look at what's called a contingency table. A table has rows and it has columns, so we can compare two different variables such as cat and dog. On the rows here is whether someone has a cat or not a cat, cat or no cat, and then in the columns is whether they have a dog or not, and then we also have a total row and a total column. Okay, so some of these numbers are going to appear over here. Well, one thing that is pretty cool right away is we can say 250 is our total. That's the grand total of all the people surveyed. Okay, then in this box, the square would be those who have a cat and those who have a dog. So which number is that going to be? Cat and dog. That's going to be 52. So the intersection is also like the intersection of the row and the column. Okay, so no cat and dog. That would be dog only, right? They don't have a cat, but they do have a dog. So that's going to be 43. Try to color code this as much as I can. But I used purple for both of these two. Then this cell or square would be those who have a cat and no dog. So that's cat only, cat and no dog. That's 128. And then this cell would be no cat and no dog. No cat and no dog is on the outside here. So that was the 27. Okay, now the other totals, and then the 250 is not really part of the Venn diagram. You can see the interior squares or cells are the four numbers from the Venn diagram. This only works for a 2x2. You can only do a Venn diagram if you have a 2x2 thing. So we still need to get our total. So let's go across. 52 plus 128 is 180. So that's our total. Oh, you know what? We did have that number. 180 said they have a cat. So then those that said they have a dog, those should add up to, these should add up to 95, right? 52 plus 43 is 95. These two, I don't think we have. How many people said they don't have a cat? So 43 plus 27 is 70. And going down, 128, oops, 128 plus 27 is 155. Okay, now I want to just double check something to make sure, just to check my math, that these two add up to 250 and those two add up to 250. So 180 plus 70. Good, it's like a double check. 95 plus 155. Great. Okay, so now I'm pretty comfortable that my table is correct. Okay, so this is just a different way of showing the information, but it's a really useful way when we start talking about probability. So that's why we're going to switch over to contingency tables. Another time it's really useful is when we have three options or more. You know, if we had dog and no dog is only two options, and that works with a circle because you can be in the circle or out of the circle. But if you have three or more options, you can't use the circles anymore. Okay, so there's four types of probabilities that we're going to find, and they're called marginal, and, or, and conditional. So let's do an example of each type. Okay, so marginal. This is what a question would look like. That's called a marginal probability. It says, find the probability that a randomly selected person from the study has a cat. So now we're not just talking about how many people, but what's the chance? If we randomly selected one of these 250 people, what's the chance they have a cat? Okay, so we want to look at how many people altogether have a cat, and we have our row totals, which are really handy. So there's 180 out of our grand total, which is 250. So altogether, oh, sorry, that was the wrong, total wrong operation. 180 divided by 250 is 0.72. Okay, 0.72 probability, or like a 72% chance. Those mean the same thing. That a person, a randomly chosen person from the study, has a cat. We could do the same thing with dog or no dog or no cat. Those are called marginal probabilities. And notice we used the numbers in the margins. That's why they call it marginal. So we're using the numbers margins or totals. Numbers in the edges. So that's the marginal probability. I'm gonna move this up just a little bit. Yeah, that's good. Okay, so now we wanna find an and probability. Find the probability that a randomly chosen person from the study has a cat and a dog. Okay, cat and a dog. So I have the probability statement already written out. Probability, cat and dog. So now we need to find in our table, where's the cat and dog? And this is the people that have a cat and a dog. It's the intersection. So that's gonna be 52 out of everyone, which is 250. Let's do that one. 52 out of 250 is 0.208. Or we could round that to 0.21. So about a 21% chance of having a cat and a dog. Okay, next is or. Scoot this up just a little bit. Okay, find the probability that a randomly chosen person from the study has a cat or no dog. So either they have a cat, or they don't have a dog, or both, as we've learned, inclusive or. Either they have a cat, or they don't have a dog. So people who have a cat are in this row, right? These folks have a cat, these have a dog, these don't have a dog. There's also people who have in this no dog column, so people who don't have a cat, but they also don't have a dog. So cats, or no dog, you see how we're really talking about these three numbers? They're either in this row or in this column. They have a cat or no dog. So I'm gonna add those three numbers together. 52 plus 128 plus 27, and all of that is gonna be out of our total of 250 people. Sorry, you can't see that. Okay. 52 plus 128 plus 27 is 207. So I'm going to write that total. 207 out of 250. And then I'll go ahead and divide that. Put it over here. 250 is 0.828. Or we could round it to 0.83. So 83%. So you might have been thinking, why didn't we use the totals for that? We could have. You might have thought to take the 180 plus the 155, and you can totally do that. The one problem is we can't count this 128 twice. If we count the 180, the 128 is in the 180, and the 128 is also in the 155. So if you did 180 plus 155, you would have to subtract 128 because you did it twice. So you can use the subtraction method or the addition method. I personally prefer the addition method, but you can do it either way. As long as you remember, if you add these two, to subtract the intersection. Okay, then there's one more type. So we've done marginal and an or. So far, these all have the same denominator, right? We were taking a probability out of the entire study, the entire number of subjects. The conditional is different. So this is what a conditional probability looks like. It says, given that a person from the study has a dog, what's the chance they have a cat? Okay, so this given is a key word. That means it's a conditional probability. You might all see another word that's if. If a person has a dog, what's the chance they have a cat? Okay, so what this is doing is saying, given, we know they have a dog, given that they have a dog, so we're only looking at dog owners. Let's write that down. So given that they have a dog, we only count dog owners. Okay, so let me pull the table down back here for a second. We're only gonna look at dog owners. So let me switch to a different color. That means we're only going to use this column. And this is for the conditional. Oops, that's above the thing. For conditional. When it's conditional, we're only going to look at a certain row or a certain column. Depends on which one it says is given. So, given that a person has a dog, what's the chance they have a cat? So 52 have a cat, but we're not taking it out of 250. We're only taking it out of 95. So the way we do this one is 52 divided by 95. So let's write that down. 52 out of 95. And let's get an answer for that. 0.5474. I'll stop it there. 5474. But then we can just do a percentage. That would be 55%. So 55% of the dog owners also have a cat. Okay? So that's an example of how to fill in a contingency table related to a Venn diagram, and also of these four types, the marginal, and, or, and conditional. Those are the four types of probability we'll be studying. All right, thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you in the next one.